We need to talk about something else.
Moving right along. How about movies? Movies of this day and age. I've only seen a couple of good ones, like the one really good one that everybody likes. Actually, somebody wanted to watch it in my intro to the university experience class, The Hangover. Now, I don't
know. Not exactly landmark, you know, 21st century cinema, but still entertaining.
Entertaining. It's not just the whole, like, drunkenness part of it either in The Hangover. There's a story involved. It's like there's all these clues that they have to follow. I found it to be very compelling, you know, even though it was just about being completely drunk and forgetting where you were. It was still very interesting. The mystery that they have to piece together, you know, the mattress impaled on, you know, the
Caesar's arm. Yeah. Yeah.
So nice, I saw it twice. Almost three times, actually.
I saw it three times.
Really?
Just, you know, I didn't really even plan to watch it that many times. It just kind of happened.
You know, it's one of those things. People are like, hey, you want to go watch The Hangover? It's not, hey, you want to go watch a movie. It's, hey, do you want to go watch The Hangover? And you usually agree to that sort of thing. It's like somebody saying, hey, you want this bag of money?
I think the best part of the entire movie is actually during the end credits when they're looking at the pictures that they took while they were on their crazy drunken rampage.
Ugh.
The guy with the beard holding the shotgun and, like, firing in the air and going, best part of the entire movie. Had to wait, you know, what, 92 minutes, whatever, to get to it, but still. It was during the credits, and it made the whole movie for me.
The little fat Jesus, yeah.
Yeah, oh, yeah, they call it Fat Jesus. That was funny.
But, still, yeah, very funny, compelling even. And, you know, it's a really good movie that there seems to be a lack of, like, a lot of good movies. I remember
we're just talking about, like, movies that are, you know, really don't have any. I mean, come on, they're just funny, they're entertaining, that's all they're supposed to be. You take a movie like, I don't know, now I realize this movie came out a long time ago, and I'm really behind the times here. I mean, come on, guys, I'm 24. I'm an old man now.
You're ancient.
I'm ancient. I finally saw the movie, the Zohan, whatever.
Oh, yeah.
That was like one of the worst movies I've ever seen.
I know,
I watched it on Netflix, watch it now.
It was already on Netflix, watch it now.
It's on Netflix, watch it now.
Really?
I watched it, it was so bad, like. And the thing was, I mean, come on, guys, it's an Adam Sandler movie. How could, you know, Adam Sandler's hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he made Happy Gilmore. That was, you know, again, not exactly landmark, you know,
it
cinema.
Was entertaining.
It was entertaining.
But, you know, when a movie ceases to be entertaining, it's not so much a movie as it is noise and pictures. And, you know, it's kind of disappointing. Like, I was waiting for the entire movie for, like, it had its funny bits, but there really wasn't, like, anything.
I don't think you can watch a movie that's supposed to be funny when you just really, you hate the main character.
Yeah, it's like the main character in the Zohan. He's like the...
He's Israeli counter-terrorist guy. Okay, you know, whatever. He decides he wants to be a hairdresser. Okay, well that's... Alright, okay, haha. You know, hilarity will ensue, I guess is where the writing went with this. It's like that was the pitch. Like, come on, he like captures terrorists and he wants to style hair.
Oh, yeah, it's like, boo, complete change.
I wonder if the guy giving the pitch even did, like, the jazz hands thing.
Ooh,
really did.
But, yeah, it leaves, you know, with that, just with the little bit in mind, like, you know, he's going from, like, the big macho counter-terrorist to the hairstylist. You think, like, there'd be, like, some, you know, like, coping issues. Like, it would be really hard for him to fit in. But it's just that it's not really
kind of like an instant.
Yeah, it just
transition.
Happens.
He just does it.
He does it. It's not like there's like some sort of
and then the whole thing, like he's styling the old women's hair, and then he proceeds to have his way with them. I guess is what we're allowed to say on the air.
The appropriate ways.
He has his way with them, but like,
his way.
I mean, I can understand like, oh yeah, they're making him out to be this, you know, this rock hard, unbending pillar of justice and everything, and then he's a hairstylist and he still kind of has to be that way. But I really don't understand why they felt they needed to include this in the movie. And then his love interest, it just seems like she's the exact same thing. It's just another person for him to have his way with. You really don't, there's not really any connection there. I mean, like, come on. Like,
yeah, there was no really deep emotional roots. It was just sort of like...
And I'm not expecting, you know, some great experience.
Yeah, I'm not expecting Gone with the Wind, you know, starring Adam Sandler.
Yeah, although that would that has the potential to be awesome. File it away in the recesses of your brain.
Being put in the folder of things very awesome that should be done soon. But yeah, you just really didn't feel for him because, you know, he was just invincible.
He's invincible.
It's like,
I mean, Happy
okay.
Gilmore. Okay, again, he gets beat up by Bob Barker. Come on,
Bob Barker.
Yes, Bob Barker.
Old
trashed him.
Trashed him completely.
I mean, we have this character who's been like. he's kind of been a screw up his whole life. His dad dies when he's a kid. He's raised by his grandmother. You know, it's like you feel bad for him, you know? And it's like his grandmother's going to get her house taken away, blah, blah, blah. He has to make money for the first time in his life, and he finds out that he can do this thing, and then, you know, we got the whole Shooter McGavin character messing up his process, and when he gets beat up and when he gets put down, you feel bad for him, but with the Zohan, it's like...
He can't be put down because he's just that invincible. There's no putting down the Zohan because he's just... He, like, folded the one guy in a pretzel that wanted to beat the one kid up that Nick Swartz in the movie. And it's just like, okay, since he can do that, did you really even need to feel for him at this point? Because